Hey there, welcome to Play Noggin. I'm Julian, your brain's player too. This week we're taking a look at No Man's Sky, and before you say it, I know this game was one of the biggest letdowns in recent gaming memory. I remember the game we thought we'd get with its massive, procedurally generated galaxy and 18 quintillion planets. Really, the only thing bigger than this game's scale were our expectations for it. So, of course, it was a letdown when it came out. And that's a shame, because there are some interesting parts of this game a sci-fi nerd would love. Landing on undiscovered planets, traveling to space stations that look like D&D dice, finding life forms that no one has ever seen before, killing them. But for us today, we wanted to talk about the main point of No Man's Sky, the whole apparent reason for shooting everything in sight with a mining laser, the center of the galaxy. How long would it take to get there? And what would we find once we arrived? The good news for us is our Milky Way galaxy is actually smaller than the one in No Man's Sky. Yeah, we made a game bigger than our own galaxy. Go humanity. The artificial galaxy has so many planets, it would take hundreds of millions of years to visit them all, even if you only spent a single second on each. We're talking 18 quintillion planets. If you want to see that written out, here it is. It's hard to pin down exactly how many planets are in our real galaxy, because it's hard to count trees in the forest when you're standing in it. But we estimate that there are anywhere from 100 billion to 400 billion stars. Give each of those at least a couple of planets, and we could have as many as 800 billion to 8 trillion extra solar planets. That's an impressive number, but not as impressive as... Jeez, that's a lot. Even more good news, our solar system isn't on the edge of the galaxy, but 24.8 to 26.7 thousand light years from the center, meaning we're about halfway there. That'll really cut down on the time it takes to grind out more iron. I'm afraid that's where the good news ends. Unlike in No Man's Sky, there's no hyperdrive or black hole shortcut to start jumping light years. As of right now, we'd have to do it the old-fashioned way of rockets and gravitational assists, like Voyager 1. Launched in 1977, Voyager 1 is the fastest man-made thing currently moving away from our solar system. It's covering about 17 kilometers every second and is over 20 billion kilometers from our sun, meaning it's actually escaped the solar system. At that distance, light from the sun takes over 19 hours to reach it. But even at its current speed, it would take 44 million years to reach galactic ground zero. That's not really very efficient. But like in No Man's Sky, the time it takes to get somewhere is very much dependent on how fast you're going. We could of course get there quicker if we could travel, say, near the speed of light. If we could get a ship going 99.9% light speed, it could cover the distance to the center in about 25,000 years, at least to an observer on Earth. But to someone on the ship, it wouldn't take so long because of relativity. As they approach the speed of light, time moves more slowly for them and distance contracts. To figure out how long it would take them, we can use the equation for time dilation. Time on the ship equals the time on Earth times the square root of 1 minus the velocity of the ship squared over the speed of light squared. If the ship has to travel for 25,000 years on Earth at 99.9% light speed to get to the center of the galaxy, when you plug all those into the equation, you get a travel time of about 1,118 years. Not great, but it beats the heck out of 44 million years. Still, you'd have to figure out some cryogenic solution or breeding strategy, or you'd have a ship full of corpses when it got to the hub of the Milky Way. It's not a very good welcoming present. So what would our ghost ship find when it got there? The darkest darkness possible. A supermassive black hole we call Sagittarius A star. Unlike regular old stellar black holes that can be as little as 5 solar masses, the one at the center of it all is 4.6 million times the mass of our sun. Though that's ridiculously huge, it doesn't have enough gravity to hold the entire galaxy together, which is why we believe dark matter exists. It's still pretty big though, so you wouldn't want to actually go near it like in No Man's Sky. You'd experience less crushing disappointment and more just straight up crushing. See, now the game's ending doesn't seem so bad. It only took hundreds of hours of pointing lasers at rocks to reach the galactic center in that game, and then all you had to do was restart, compared to thousands of years of traveling just to be crushed to death. So that's the center of the galaxy done and dusted. But I have one more question I'd like to tackle. How long would it take to travel to the center of the universe? That's tricky. First of all, you might be wondering just how big our universe is. When we attempt to measure it by using light from distant stars as picked up by our incredibly powerful telescopes, we can only see as far as time will let us. Since the universe is about 13.8 billion years old, that means the farthest stars we can see were 13.8 billion light years away when they started shining in our direction. This is what's called the observable universe. Even if the light we're seeing took 13.8 billion years to reach us, those stars are now 46 billion light years away because the space between us and them has stretched out. Our best estimates right now suggest that the entire universe is somewhere in the ballpark of 250 times the size of the parts that we can observe. Okay, even I'm starting to glaze over trying to picture that. That's of course assuming the universe isn't infinite. But if it is infinite, you can still get to the center. Because space is stretching out in all directions and appears to be doing so uniformly, that means from any given point, everything appears to be moving away from you. That means that technically, and as far as we know, everywhere is the center of the universe. So it would take crazy long to get to the middle of the galaxy, but you could already be at the center of the universe right now. Did I just blow your mind? Hey, thanks for watching. As always, if you like what you saw, give us a like and please subscribe. Check out some of our other videos right here. And if you have any ideas for games you'd like to see us cover, drop it in the comments below. And don't forget to keep on playing.